Hey, Eisenstein there, my friends. Dr. Alan here, and today we have to talk about this recent groundbreaking news. In a historical medical achievement, we now have the first successful total eye transplant. This story involves a gentleman named Aaron James, a 46-year-old U.S. military veteran who tragically lost his left arm, majority of his face, and his left eye in a devastating work accident involving high electrical voltage power lines. And almost 6 months ago, in May of 2023, Mr. James went through the very intricate process of having facial tissue and a complete left eye transplanted from a single donor. And this procedure took over 100 medical professionals all collaborating to even make this possible. And I can tell you just from how complex the eye is, this procedure sounds just like crazy difficult because they had to attach 6 muscles around the eye. They had to make sure blood supply was getting to the outer part of the eye and to the inner part of the eye, like the retina. Plus, they have to attach the optic nerve of the donor eye to the existing optic nerve of Mr. James. And get this, to promote healing, adult stem cells were taken from the donor's bone marrow and was injected into the optic nerve to help promote healing and help with regeneration of the nerve. So now the burning question that is on everybody's mind is, can Mr. James see through that transplanted eye? And unfortunately, the answer is no. Even in this photo here where we can see the transplanted eye, it doesn't seem like he really has full control of the eye muscles either, because the transplanted eye really isn't in alignment with his working blue eye. However, they are reporting some pretty exciting news in that the transplanted eye is showing good blood flow to the ocular tissues, including the retina in the back of the eye, that the eye is holding good stable eye pressure, which I think is pretty exciting, and they're showing some electrical activity from the eye going to the brain. Which, knowing that, I think gives us a lot of hope. So some people may ask, well, if Mr. James can't see with the transplanted eye, then why is this news so groundbreaking? Well, interestingly enough, while tissues of the eye are frequently transplanted, like corneal transplants happen to be one of the most common transplanted tissues around the globe, transplanting a whole eye into somebody's eye socket and for that eye to successfully like attach and start even having some function and working has never been really done before. And that's basically because the whole eye is such a complex organ, with the retina tissue and the optic nerve basically being an extension of your brain. It is neural tissue. So not only do the doctors have to be worried about just the organ tissue being rejected by the host, but trying to connect two optic nerves together seems nearly impossible. And that's because the optic nerve of the eye has over 1 million individual nerves within it, right? And trying to connect all of those nerves, like connecting AB nerve of the donor eye to the AB nerve of the recipient eye, it's just too complex and nearly impossible to do that. Even in a hypothetical case where the nerve was able to be healthy, but the nerves were all mixed up, the human brain would have to relearn what all of that data visual information from the eyeball meant, meaning basically relearning how to see. And not just relearning how to see with one eye, but how the information from the new eye is going to connect and overlap and make sense with the information coming from the other eye. So knowing how crazy the visual components of our brain is and how complex the nerve is, if Mr. James gets any usable vision at all, will be a huge victory in the world of medicine. And I think that is why this story is so monumental, because it's basically the first step in the direction of almost curing blindness. I mean, it's definitely exciting and kind of pushing the boundary of what we define as impossible in the world of healthcare. Now, of course, with this story, I do want to wish many healing thoughts and great success to Aaron as he continues. I want to send kudos out to all of the doctors and healthcare professionals who helped out with this amazing breakthrough. And then extra special kudos to the donor and the donor's family, because being an organ donor is huge, can save and transform people's lives. And so with that, please let me know in the comments what you think of this story. And are you an organ donor? Yes or no? Why and why not? Otherwise, please share this video with your friends and family, because I think it is just a very cool, special story. Otherwise, Thank you so much for watching. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in that next video.